Hi everyone, John Mitchell here, Mayor of New Bedford. This is another installment of the Mayor's Weekly Update. So I wanted to talk today, as we do every week, about COVID. A lot's happening right now. I think the first thing to report is that we have been experiencing here in New Bedford and the region a decline in cases that is mirroring the national decline. 2 weeks ago, the two-week average number of daily cases in the city was at about 133. Right now, it's at 83. So that's a pretty significant drop, roughly 40%. And it looks like that's going to continue. So that's all good news. The positive rate of tests has also gone down as well. 2 weeks ago, it was at about 15%. Now it's down to about 9.5%. So that's also good progress, even though the number of tests administered has remained roughly the same. So it's a positive trend. Hospitalizations are coming down, although not as fast as they are at the national level. And at the same time, the surge facility that we opened in the far north end is working. There are about 45 patients admitted there now. That's helped decompress the hospital system. So we have to keep it going. The decline in cases is attributable to the fact that after Christmas, after New Year's, people haven't been getting together. They've been keeping their masks on. It hasn't been as a result of the vaccines just yet. So the key is to keep that going. We want to continue to push that number down. And so we're coming up on a big weekend where we have to be prepared. Super Bowl weekend, people get together. They have their dinners. They have their... get together and watch the game. We really can't be doing that this year. Patriots aren't in it, of course. Tom Brady is. I get it, but we have to refrain from it. And then if we're able to get through that successfully, we should expect a continuing decline in cases. The new variants are out there. That's something that we have to be concerned about, of course, and we'll keep you informed if things start to change on that front. Obviously, our focus these days is on vaccine distribution. The hard reality is this: there isn't much vaccine here. The federal government has not distributed much. We anticipate that will increase in the next several weeks. It just hasn't happened yet. So, for instance, here in New Bedford, we have our healthcare providers, which are vaccinating their existing patients. And then there are a couple of pharmacies that are also having people sign up. The city itself is getting about 400 doses of vaccine, and we've been using the lion's share of that by going directly to senior living facilities to make sure that our seniors have their vaccines. That's really important for reasons we're all familiar with now, that there was a strong connection between age and serious illness from COVID. Here in New Bedford, about 90% of the deaths have come from people over the age of 70, about 90%. So our charge right now is to get our seniors vaccinated as soon as we get our hands on the vaccines. And so that's what we've been doing. We have a clinic at the Andre McCoy Rec Center. We don't have a lot of vaccines yet for that place. Once vaccines start coming in, then we'll really be able to ramp it up. So I know some people have tried to get appointments there. The reality is that we have fewer than 100 vaccines left at that site to vaccinate people. And so we all need to be patient. It is hard because it's been a long pandemic, but I do think that in the weeks ahead, we're going to see more vaccine, and we want to continue to be, we want to be ready for when it comes, and then we'll be able to put a big dent in this pandemic. So stay tuned, more to come, and until next week, this has been the Mayor's Weekly Update.